This filter was invented in 2005, and what we found out is the people on our technical lines that take calls from dealers started noticing unexplainable problems occurring with engines. We contacted some other manufacturers. They were having them too. We came to find out that ethanol had been introduced and was causing problems in the engines. So specifically to combat that, we co-invented this filter. What ethanol does is it's hygroscopic, which means it attracts water directly out of the atmosphere. And that separates out of the gasoline once you reach 0.5%. It's what they call phase separation. The fuel pump then, when the engine is running, is going to try to bring, typically the pickup is in the bottom of the tank, and it's going to bring that water and attempt to get it into the engine. What the fuel water separator does is it not only cleans the debris out of the fuel, but it also, water being heavier than fuel, it'll drop to the bottom of the filter and be collected here, whereas only clean gas will go into the engine from there. There's two different sizes. There's the large, what we call the 10 micron filter, and it comes with either a stainless steel head or an aluminum head. And then we make what's known as the mini 10, and that's for 115 horsepower and down, and it comes with aluminum only head. The filter is 10 micron, which is about 1/20th the diameter of a human hair. And with this filter is actually about a 95% nominal efficiency rate, meaning that 95% of 10 micron or more particles will be captured by the filter. A lot of filters out on the market, they can call themselves 10 micron and capture much less of that. This filter, very easy to install, just takes a very minimal amount of experience and some easy tools. You simply mount this in the stern area of the boat. You'd interrupt the fuel line, mount a fitting on either end. Fuel comes in, fuel goes out. The fittings come with it. It's very easy to install. Unless it's a new boat with a new engine, we ask that you change this. It's a good idea to change it at 10 hours, the first 10 hours of operation, and then every 50 hours after that.